it cool. Used to be a fool, all about the bounce in my step. Watch it on the news, what you gonna do? I could hit refresh and forget. Used to keep it cool.
So I put a piece of blue tape on the bottom of it just in case, so I can fill it with super glue without it worrying about it getting glued down to the actual CNC. So we're using some Starbond medium super glue with a bit of accelerator, and then we can take one final pass with the bowl bit. I went in an offset on the original passes because it was faster, but on this final pass I'm doing a very small step down and doing a pass with the grain. This will help prevent any sort of excess sanding, as going with the grain will always provide a smoother finish. So you can see that that knot filled really nicely. Now we're going to engrave the bottom of it with the 45771-K 30 degree engraving bit, and I'm just going to put in my wife and I's anniversary date. So this is definitely making it a little more customized and special. So
here we are, part three of making the fishing lure for my buddy out of the tree that got cut down in his backyard. There's a whole bunch of sanding. I left a lot of it off camera just because it would get boring rather quickly. But I'm really going for that tuna shape is what I call it, where there's no square edges. It's got a nice round profile raindrop shape from head to toe. Or I guess it'd be head to fin, tail fin. Yeah, but it gets pretty messy, so it's important to dust off in between sessions. Also, I apologize if any of that ever shows up on the lens when I'm not paying attention. But there you go, you can see the nice profile of it. Starting to look pretty killer, getting a whole bunch of hand sanding done, and it is K9 approved. We need to test that, so he approves. I think it's going to...
So here's a bit of a sneak peek of what I'm working on. I've been trying for the very first time to do some curve cuts to curve plywood, and it's actually worked really well. Never done it before. So you've got a pretty nice curve that's going over 90, so to be able to clamp it square. But this is actually going to be for a bin in my bedroom, just as a practice, because I want to do all bedroom furniture curved. But so far so good.
guy in the background is my fishing buddy. He recently had a tree cut down in his backyard and was kind of sad about it, so I figured I would make him a lure out of his tree. I found that awesome grain pattern that I really like, so I figured I'd base the lure around that. And here I am gluing on the pattern, which is going to be a two-piece swim bait. It's going to be kind of a smaller one shaped similar to that of a shad. And because I don't have a bandsaw, I went ahead and cut off all the extra pieces as close as I could without crossing the line. That way, when I go to sand it, I'm not wasting all the sandpaper on my belt sander. And there was quite a bit of cutting. It took some patience, but that's okay. So here we are. I'm going to go ahead and sand it to shape. And because I only have a minute to show you guys everything, I'm going to do a couple different parts. I only had time to do one part today, but I'm hoping tomorrow I'll get part two and three up, and then we'll get it painted later this week. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you had an awesome Sunday, and I will catch you in the next one. This is part two of building a fishing lure for my friend. We left off last time cutting the joint, so we went ahead and got both sides cut, but not all the way through. That way we can get everything sanded to shape and do the final cut later. Here I am sketching on the shape that I'm going for, and you can see how it's fat at the front and narrows down at the end. I did manage to film this part, but I forgot to hit record when I was sanding the back half of the bait, so you'll just have to imagine that part. But here's what she looks like, getting that raindrop shape going on. I went ahead and drilled out the eye sockets while everything's still square for the most part. And then I put it into the vise to drill out the holes for the lead weight. I had a couple people say something on the last video about wood floating. And yes, wood does float, which is why we're going to put some lead in there later to get it to sink. And now we're just going to go ahead and sand it on down to shape. And if you're seeing this video, that means part three is already available to watch. Hoping to get part four up as soon as I can. Thank you guys. I'll catch you in the next one.
Underground, load of merch in that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up.
Down, down, down. Da da da. 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 Da da da.
Hey Ted and the rest of the team over at Ted's Woodworking. It's John here from the UK, and I can't thank you enough for the plans. I can build things now that I never thought possible for me to do and make them look good. If I had to boil it down to just one single moment, I think the catalyst that started my woodworking journey, it would be the time when I purchased Ted's collection of plans. All I can say is, if you have ever wanted to get into woodworking and didn't know where to start, this is the package to get. You'll find plans to almost any project that you can think of, which makes it very easy to get started.
Hey everyone, Barry here in Nebraska. I'd like to give a big shout out to Ted. I recently came across Ted's woodworking online course, and I'm so glad that I did. The amount of plans included with the program simply blew my mind. The content they offer with the course provided me with so many ideas for creative projects, as well as some awesome furniture ideas and plans that my wife now wants in our home. If you're considering buying Ted's woodworking course, the return on your investment will be lifelong. Being one that loves woodworking, I have to say, they offer the most detailed collection of plans I've ever seen. I would also rank it as one of the best values of any woodworking course I've ever taken. Thanks for creating it, Ted. You did well.